Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new. So you may have guessed that this is my Polish pickup wish list for the month of October of 2024. And I'm so excited for this month. I cannot believe how excited I am for this month because I swear when I saw the theme and I saw the spoilers, my reaction was just meh. I'm shrugging. You guys can't see me shrugging, but I'm shrugging. And I just didn't think anything of it. I feel like I'm having deja vu to that one year where the theme was fauna and something. But I remember being so dismissive about that theme. And then I fell in love with like almost everything. This happened again for this theme. Oh, let me show you the theme. So the theme is natural phenomenons. I feel like I'm saying that wrong. I feel like I should go phenomenon, da, 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 da. Okay, I gotta stop. It's late when I'm recording this. I'm sorry. I'm feeling a little punchy. Anywho, the pre-order starts on October the 4th through the 7th. Polish pickup is always on the first weekend of every month. I have the FAQs up here explaining how Polish pickup works, but basically it is a collaboration, a monthly event that happens in a pre-order setup. If you are part of the Polish Pickup Facebook group, you can vote for future themes. Once you order, after the last day, which would be on the, what day was that? The 7th. After the 7th, they start packaging everything. So you can expect your product to arrive like 3 to 4 weeks. Let's get started because I have a lot on my wish list. And this is only the polishes. I haven't even looked at the... I haven't even looked at the hand nail section. I haven't looked at the miscellaneous section or merchandise. I just went to the nail polishes. I did start from Z to A to give everybody a fair chance. I think I do Z to A a lot more than I do A to Z, but I figured a lot of people do A to Z, so it's nice to change it up some. Some of these are polishes that were influenced, or I was influenced to add to my wish list after seeing it in a swatch video. I try not to watch those before I make my wishlist video, but I couldn't help it. I had questions and I needed answers. So let's get started. The first one we're going to talk about is a zombie claw, and this is in paranormal. It's going to be $13.50. I forgot to mention, if I say something is capped, that usually means it they're only making a certain amount. And here for a zombie claw, they are capping it at 300. So unless she has enough materials to make more and there's a high demand on it, you're not going to see this after the 300. That's it. Anyways, inspired by paranormal phenomenon, a haunting thermal that is clear to dark gray black loaded with black flakes. I knew this was a thermal. I've mentioned this before. I'm not a big fan of thermals. I knew this was a thermal, but good grief, do I like this. I like this a lot. Like, there is something about this that just... it just does it for me. I kind of want to get it, but I don't like thermals. So no, I'm not going to get it, but I just had to bring it up to everyone's attention. If you like thermals and this looks like spot on, like spookylicious, that's the best way I can think of, you should get this. The minute I saw it, I was like, oh, and then I saw it was a thermal. I said, oh. Next, we have Wildflower Lacquer, and this is in Glass Rose. This is going to be $13.75. Good grief. I feel like I'm not even going to talk about that. It's inspired by a photo of a frozen rose that was taken back in Oklahoma ice storm of 2020. It is a berry base with blue to purple shifting shimmer and holographic flakes. $2 of this polish will be donated to support relief efforts for those impacted by Hurricane Helene. Charity of choice is to be announced. There is no cap on this one. If you've been here before, you know that I love me some Wildflower Lacquer, but I feel like I have this polish, this exact polish in Polish for Days Look Alive. Correct me if I'm wrong. I haven't seen any comparisons just yet, but this is giving me Look Alive vibes, and that is why I am kicking it off of the running for me. I already have Lookalive. I absolutely love Lookalive. I don't need another dupe. I already do that enough with other colors. I don't need to do that with this. So this is removed from my wish list. I feel so good, but I know that these are false starts. These are totally false starts, but I right now feel so good that I'm taking stuff off my wish list because I think I have like 9 or 10 things on my wish list. Again, only the polishes, not the products. Next, we have Sweet and Sour Lacquer, and this is called Acidic Abyss. It's going to be $13, and it is capped at 500. It is inspired by Danakil Depression in Ethiopia. If I'm not saying this right, I apologize. Olive green jelly base with lime green metallic flakes and a copper orange green iridescent flakes. Wow. Look at this. Look at this. How freaking gorgeous is this? I love it. I do. Do I have something like it? I want to say yes. I want to say I have something like this. And that is why I think I'm going to kick it out of the running. Because I feel like I have something like this, because this is such a color that I would choose. Oh my gosh, I hope I don't regret this life choice. This polish originally was not on my radar. Mercedes from Hey Mercedes, she totally influenced me to get this one because it just looks so beautiful on her. I mean, this is her swatch. Where did her swatch go? That's her swatch right there. Isn't that gorgeous? And the video looks even better. Mercedes, I need to stop watching her. I love you, girl, but you're killing my wallet. In my bones, I feel like I have something like this, so I'm going to remove it from my wish list. Next, we have Restored by Polish, and this is called Solar Flare. This is going to be $13.50, and it is capped at 100 bottles. Inspired by solar flares, high intensity eruptions on the sun's surface, often accompanied by corneal mass ejections. Corneal? Am I saying that right? The natural phenomenon theme gave us the opportunity to choose a current phenomenon that has been making its presence known lately with the widespread viewing of the Aurora Borealis, otherwise known as Northern Lights. Solar Flare is a blood orange jelly base with fiery flakes throughout. It also has a gold aurora shimmer. It is opaque in two coats, but three gives this polish more intensity. I love it. I love it. This looks so pretty. I'm digging the oranges right now. It's fall and it's gonna be October, and I'm ready for this. This looks gorgeous. I am going to keep this on my wish list for now because I really, really like it, but I do have a lot of oranges, and I'm trying towards the end of this year to not buy as many dupes for myself. I have failed profusely, immensely. That's right. I have failed immensely so far. I'm trying, but I'm going to keep this because I really, really like it. Next, we have Red Eye Lacquer in Fireflies. This is going to be $12.50. This is inspired by Fireflies Glowing. It is capped at 200. It is described as a deep navy jelly with gold, orange, green shifting flakes, black flakes, and a yellow green glow in the dark. Ooh, pretty. All right. Again. I'm looking at this and I'm loving this. This glow in the dark, that's cool, but it's not really what's calling to me. This polish is just gorgeous. The problem, I think I have something like it. I think I have something so, so close to it. And if not exact dupe, I can create this one. I have a strong suspicion that I can. So because of that, I think I'm gonna destash this one. And this is gorgeous. This is just so gorgeous. But again, it's just hitting, like, it's giving me that alert, you have something like it. Next, we have Polish for Days Out of This World. This is going to be $13.50, and there is no cap. There usually isn't with Polish for Days. This is inspired by the Northern Lights again. It is a deep teal base with extremely shifty purple, pink, orange, yellow, green, shifting, multi-chrome, micro flake shimmer. Whew, I feel like I was like one of those micro machine announcers. If you're old enough to remember that, give me a like, please. This is gorgeous. Freaking night, man. It's just freaking night. I can't even, like, it's making me tongue-tied. It's so freaking beautiful. These pictures are wonderful. However, I think I'm going to see mostly this, like mostly this. And if I see mostly this, I have something that is mostly this. And I don't know. Like a part of me is like, don't miss out. Don't get the FOMO, you know, because Goblins and Ghoulies, I don't know, it was beautiful, but Barbie on the Boardwalk, another polish for days that I was just kind of like, oh, it's beautiful, but eh. And then I was like, oh my God, I can't, I don't have that. I don't want to go through that again. I just don't like going through the FOMO. And this one may or may not give me FOMO. I have to look at more swatches, but this is what I believe I'm gonna see the most of. And if I see just this, I'm gonna be a little bit PO'd about it. I'm not gonna lie. So it's on my wish list for now, until further notice. I'm gonna keep it on here. It's beautiful, because even when it's like this, it's beautiful. But again, I have something like that, so I'm gonna keep it on my wish list for now. Next we have Painted Polish Live Laugh Lava. This is gonna be $13 and there is no cap. It is inspired by the powerful force of natural phenomenon that is lava. Vampy dark scarlet base with crushed gold metallic flakes. Sounds so simple, and yet you get this. Look at this. Look at this. Oh my goodness. I love this. I love this. But I feel like I have something like it. I hang my head in shame. Because this is just so freaking gorgeous. And I don't want to say no to it, but oh gosh, I'm going to have to keep it for now. Yeah, I'm going to keep it for now. Next, we have Polish in Moonbow, and this is going to be $14. Oh God, that just hurts something deep inside me. This is not capped, and it is inspired by Moonbows. It's a sheer violet base packed with copper, pink, green, shifting microflakes. What are Moonbows? What are those? Is that a thing? I need to look this up. But this polish, the pictures are very deceiving, because this polish looks kind of like meh, okay, it's pretty, but then I saw the video of Mercedes right up here, this little devil on my shoulder saying, get it, it's so pretty, and it did. It looked really, really amazing. So I think I'm going to purchase this. I haven't purchased polish brand since they went up to $14 on PPU. So however long it's been since they started doing $14, that's when I quit buying from them. Apparently I'm giving in now, but I may or may not keep this. As of right now, it's staying on my wish list. Next we have Garden Path Lacquer in Told the Northern Lights to Keep Shining. This is capped at 1,000. That's a big cap. I love it. Inspired by the Northern Lights, I was able to see from my home in, what is it, Northeast Ohio? Is that what it is? Yep, that's what it is. In May of 2024. I'm so jealous of everybody who saw the dang Northern Lights, because I didn't see the Northern Lights. I went out. I didn't see them. I was annoyed. Told the Northern Lights to Keep Shining is a grape purple base filled with magenta holographic micro glitters, blue green aurora shimmer, and holographic micro flakes. Wow, wow, wow. This looks gorgeous. I mean, Garden Path Lacquer has a knack for making these polishes that just look so, I don't even know how to explain how beautiful I think this looks. So do I want this one? Most definitely. Do I have something like it? Most probably. So right now I am going to keep it, but I think this one will be getting kicked off if I can think of something that looks similar enough to kick it out of the way. Oh my gosh. Next we have Dreamland Lacquer, and this is $13 and it is capped at 600. It is inspired by the beautiful photos taken of the intense aurora activity this summer. Again, Northern Lights. A purple multichrome magnetic that shifts purple, pink, orange, green with pink, gold, green, shifty, tiny flakes. There are a ton of magnetic polish offerings this month, and it is giving my magnetic loving heart palpitations. But some of them look similar enough to something else that I have, so I'm not gonna even showcase them. But anything that's magnetic, you best believe that I was staring at it for a really long time before I decided not to add it on my wish list. Anyways, back to this Dreamland Lacquer. Look at this. Look. I mean, come on. Need I say more? Need I say more? Look at. Seriously. No words. This is gorgeous. This, oh, that's so cute. This is phenomenal. I really, really like this. I'm trying to see if I have something like it or similar enough colors, because I did purchase a couple of magnetics in the past couple of months, which reminds me, I haven't done a haul video since about June. So I have July, August, and September to share with you all. And I have some magnetics. I don't think any of those magnetics look like this, but I mean, I have to have something like this, something similar enough that I don't need this, right? I'm gonna keep it for now. Next, we have Catalocker and Everlasting Storm. This is gonna be $14. Gosh, that really hurts to say. It is inspired by lightning. It is a dusty blue base with strong magenta. There we go. Magenta to orange to yellow shimmer. I'm sorry. That was silly. Oh, I'm so tired. This is a must have. This is a must have for me this month. Like, if I get rid of everything else, I'm buying this one. I love the way it looks. I saw video evidence of this beauty on the nails shifting like nobody's business. Of course, it was from Hey Mercedes. This late, look, she just popped up. You saw that. She just popped up as I'm saying it. I didn't know that was going to come up. This is the first time I'm looking at all the photos like this. Okay, anywho. This polish is gorgeous. And then the last polish that I'm going to talk about is this BCB Lacquers. It's a phenomenon. Okay, really? No, you're just playing with me now. It's going to be $13.50. There is a cap of 400. It is inspired by Chappelle Rowan's song, That. I don't even know how to say that. This is a black jelly with purple blue magnetic pole, pink orange glass flakes, and green purple blue glass flakes. First of all, wow. Like, I love it. It's so pretty. Oh my gosh, it's so pretty. Again, this one, I feel like I have something similar to it. Oh, this is so pretty. She's another one that's on my hit list, because she makes me want to buy everything, because on her, everything looks amazing. And Elisa, if you're watching this, this is your fault. I don't even know. I'm going to keep it for now. Dang it. I'm going to keep it for now. 8 polishes on my wish list for the month of October. You know that can't happen. And I see a common color theme, and apparently it's purple. I mean, that's a lot of purple. I love purple, but that's a lot of purple. So, let me know what you all are thinking about getting. Help me cut this down. Help me cut this down, because good grief, Carolina. No, this is just, es demasiado. It's too much. It's just too much. Why is everything so good this month? Let me know in the comments down below if you have any of the same ones that I do, and if you do, which one are you going to cut off, and which one is your must-have? I would love to know what is your must-have. Thank you so much, everyone, for taking the time of the day to watch this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you all in my next one. Bye!